You're listening to the Renaissance Men podcast with Stuart Garrard and David Robert Bridge. Follow us at Renaissance Pod on Twitter for regular updates on the show and its content, and to find all of the links to our distributors, such as Player FM, Stitcher Radio, and iTunes. The Renaissance Men podcast will begin in 3, 2, 1.
Welcome to the Renaissance Men Podcast, episode 13, for Monday, 6th of October, 2014. My name is Stuart Skinbear Garrard, and also, as always, I'm joined by my co-host, David Robert Bridge.
Hello.
DRB, how are you?
I'm very well, sir. How are you?
I'm okay. Is there a reason why you're doing a sex voice?
What sex voice? This is my normal speaking voice.
Okay, have you had a stroke?
You're clearly not fooled by it, fine.
No.
I'm just trying my 13. Sexy new voice, that's all.
Oh, God. Well, I will admit, I was a little bit aroused.
Yeah.
Shockingly so, to be honest. Episode 13, unlucky for some. Are you a particularly superstitious man, DRB?
Nope. You?
Nope. Moving on.
That means nothing.
The Renaissance Men podcast, as always, is available through iTunes, Stitcher, and Player FM. I'm thinking how easy is it to get onto SoundCloud, DRB? I'm thinking we might need to, should get up there maybe?
It really couldn't be easier. I could survive for you if you like.
I think that might be prudent, actually. Just get us out there as to as many people as we possibly can.
Yes, although I know without a fancy account, you can only host about 2 hours worth of audio, so that'd be about 2 episodes for us at a time. But
yeah, okay. If you want to contact us on Twitter, we are at Renaissance Pod. So this is our first real main podcast since I've had my anniversary.
Mm-hmm.
It was amazing. I mentioned it briefly on the botchcast on Friday. But 2 weekends ago, me and my wife, Amanda, went off to Dunstan Hall in Norfolk, where we had a thoroughly amazing weekend in an awesome hotel.
Well, good for you.
Do you want to know what I got her?
Hopefully nothing from the Amazon reviews game.
Damn,
Natural Harvest or something like that.
What was that, Bieber? What was it? Justin Bieber? Ah, that's it. opportunity lost there, DRB. No, Amanda has this crazy idea that she wants to follow the whole, themed gifts. So your first anniversary is paper. We got gifts based on the whole paper theme. So stretching that a bit further, I thought paper, card, what could I do with a card? I phoned the hotel to arrange for a card to be placed in the room that stated, happy anniversary, Amanda, I hope you enjoy your spa treatment, which I'd booked for her, which was an Indian head massage. Yes.
But it was written on paper.
Oh, it was on card, but, you know.
Well,
so that's that. How romantic is that? Yeah,
out of 10, it's like a 6, maybe. I don't know. It's okay.
Amanda, on the other hand, got me some awesome collection of random comic books off eBay.
Made of paper.
So I thought that, yeah, it's very good. I had some weird ones in there. ElfQuest. Never heard of that. A Marvel comic called ElfQuest. Got some Spider-Man, some X-Men in there. So, yeah, awesome. I think I do have another half to my present that's on its way, but it's been delayed, so
involving
looking forward to
paper.
That. Yes.
Yes. I'm catching on.
I'm not sure what next year's will be. I think it's cotton, so fuck knows what you do with that.
I'll
Some kind
up.
Of sensible underwear, I think, may be required.
Second
but anyway, that was it.
Present.
That was our anniversary, and we enjoyed it thoroughly, so here's to another, I don't know, 50 years. Oh, yeah.
50.
Anyway,
yes,
DRB.
Right, it is cotton.
Is it really?
Maybe take her to a cotton field and get her a slave. No.
Controversial. Yeah. Well, why not? Go or cotton picking.
Is that illegal now? I'm not sure.
DRB, it's the witching season. It's October.
Yes, it is, yes.
I love Halloween. I really, really love it. Do you partake in
witchery?
Celebrating?
Witchcraft? No, I wouldn't say I'm usually the kind of chap that gets dressed up and knocks on people's doors and that sort of
thing. Fair enough. Well, I don't celebrate it like an 8-year-old child. I don't know what you're implying. To celebrate, we're going to host our very first, not us as in the Renaissance men, I'm talking about us as in me and my wife, we're going to host our very first Halloween party.
Ah.
Yeah, on the night of Halloween. So we're going to get fancy dress. There's a theme, zombies versus survivors. We're going to play games. That's going to be awesome. There's going to be a buffet themed around body parts. So
sweet.
We're talking mozzarella eyeballs, sausages for intestines, etc., etc. So can't wait for that.
Nice. I look forward to it.
You're assuming you're invited.
Why wouldn't you want me there?
Yeah. Moving on. Going on with Halloween. I think I'm going to do... I've got a little project in mind. I've named it the Scared Bitch Project.
Uh-huh.
And essentially, I want to celebrate Halloween by watching my favourite horror films, playing my favourite horror games, and just generally immersing myself in everything horror-related for the next month. So on the next few shows, I'm going to be reviewing my favourite... some favourite and some new... unwatched horror films. I shall be playing some horror video games, and I shall be obviously giving you my opinion on said games and films. Mm-hmm. So look forward to that.
I will. It sounds horrible.
Very good. So there you go. That's how are you anyway? I don't think I've asked that yet, and we're 5 minutes into the show.
I don't remember. I'm fine. Whatever. Let's get on with this.
let's take our customary lighter look at the news.
Love and marriage, love and marriage, go together like a horse and carriage. This I tell you, brother, you can't have one without the other. Love and marriage, it's an institute you can't disparage. Ask the local gentry, and they will say it's elementary. Try to separate them.
And welcome back. It's that time again. We have to look at the lighter side of the news. This week, I've got two more stories for you, DRB. My first story is from the www.9news.com. So it's an American website, news website, and story reads... Police in Pennsylvania say a man accused of shooting a bullet through a neighbor's window told a judge he fired the gun because it was the only way he knew how to unload it. Yeah. Middletown Detective Patrick Nicastro tells the Bucks County Courier Times that 31-year-old George Byrd IV of Pendle at first denied being behind the shooting, but then acknowledged during his arraignment that he fired the weapon to clear the chamber because he was unfamiliar with guns. There is a moral here, I think, DRB. It's don't give guns to people who don't know how to use guns.
Well, isn't that in the Constitution somewhere?
Unfortunately, I think, yes, it's apparently your birthright to be ridiculously stupid with handguns.
Yes.
In America.
That's how it's worded too.
I think it is. Stupid dude does stupid things with guns. That was my first story. Bit of a tit. My second story is a little, it's not tragic in a sense, but it's, I guess you could look at this in two ways. It's either, you would either consider it amazing or a bit of a curse, to be honest. This is from the New York Post, and the headline reads, "The Living Hell of a Man Who Orgasms 100 Times a Day."
Oof.
Yes. He must be knackered the whole time. He must want to sleep and smoke constantly.
Yeah, that's that sounds fun, but I'm sure it's not.
It's not. Anyway, experiencing 100 orgasms a day may sound like the gift that keeps on giving, but a heartbroken man from Wisconsin can assure you it's much more of a curse. Yeah. Dale Decker, that sounds like a porn star name anyway.
It does.
is a 37-year-old husband and father of two, just two, who suffers from an uncontrollable condition known as persistent genital arousal syndrome. Oof. That's the greatest name for a syndrome I've ever heard. He first felt the symptoms after he slipped a disc in his back and was on his way to the hospital. Decker inexplicably ejaculated five times on the drive and says the and says the orgasms have kept on coming ever since. Pardon the term.
Oh, it's...
Imagine being on your knees at your father's funeral beside beside his casket, saying goodbye to him. And then you have nine.
Keep it together, man.
Nine orgasms right there, he said. While your whole family is standing behind you. Yes, that is quite the curse.
Stand behind him and in front of him.
That is true. Oh. So, Dale Decker, I salute you. And I feel your pain, man. And he salutes me. Yes. So there you go. They are my new stories. That's it, mate.
Lovely. Do we have any serious news this week?
I don't really know. I guess we've gone to war, but I don't...
Oh, yeah.
You know, what's new, I guess.
Yeah. War in the Middle East.
War, what is it good for?
Absolutely nothing.
That's so I hear.
Say it again.
So, yeah. Yes, not to make light of us going to war, but...
Well, it happens so often now, it's...
It does, it seems like an everyday occurrence. I mean, I don't personally feel qualified enough to discuss the reasons behind us going to war. I just, you know, war is war. No war is good, so... I don't know.
Whatever.
Bad times, man.
Now let's talk some TV instead.
Let's do this. TV. Let's talk TV. Let's talk some TV, DRB.
All right, then.
Do you want to start? Do you want to go into your Big Bang Theory chatter?
No, not really. I don't know. Yeah, I can do. Well, Big Bang Theory, we've got the first three episodes of the new season out of the way. I'm guessing you haven't seen them yet.
I haven't. Nope. How are we going to go about this?
That's a good question.
We didn't really think of this, did we? I need to start watching it, don't I?
I'll send you a cheeky link. But all I say for now is I'm enjoying it. It's all right. It's good.
Okay. Have they, without saying anything about what's happened, do we know what happened to Sheldon? I'm assuming they've addressed that.
Yes.
Okay. Excellent. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure what else we can talk about that without spoiling it.
Penny's hair is short.
I noticed that. From what I remember, it doesn't suit her.
No, not really.
No, they. I think there was a photograph of them on Entertainment Weekly or some such magazine. And I thought, no, you don't suit short hair. You look like a little boy.
Yes.
Ooh. Such a shame.
Mm-hmm. Lesbian.
But are you enjoying it? Are the first three episodes, have they been good?
Yes, they've been pretty good. We're not jumping sharks just yet.
Excellent.
Yeah, I'll send you a cheeky little link and you can catch up.
If you could do it, yeah, that'd be great. And then we'll chat about it more next week once we've both seen it.
Sure.
I have been watching a few things. Obviously, I've been watching some telly.
Mm-hmm.
There's been three episodes, but I've watched two of them. The Strain has started on Watch, the TV channel Watch. It is a horror TV show. It is, I think it's produced and I think directed by Guillermo del Toro of Pan's Labyrinth fame. And, I can't remember what else he's done, but he's done some good quality horror films. And he did Pacific Rim. Have you seen Pacific Rim? Directed that?
Yes, I did.
Or did he direct it, or did he produce it? One of the two. Anyway, okay. it's a cracking TV show. Two episodes in. It's set in, I believe, New York City. The premise is, so far, a plane came into land at, I think it's JFK, and everyone on board had died of some mysterious illness, which so far in the first few episodes has transpired that this is some kind of zombie-like some zombie-like vampire-esque disease that turns people into... It's weird, they die, but they come back alive as vampires, so it's kind of... It's very good, it's very violent, and it's well done, very well done. I'm enjoying it immensely.
Sweet.
So that's going to continue. I think I've got the third episode to watch, so I'll watch that this weekend. So I recommend it if you're into horror.
I shall keep a weather eye on the horizon for the Strain.
Are you a horror fan? I don't really know.
I could take it or leave it, but it's not the worst.
Okay, cool. Fargo. I'm getting to the end of Fargo now. I watched episodes 7 and 8 during this past break. What to say about Fargo? It's really... These last two episodes have been really interesting. In so much that despite Lester Nygaard, who is played by Martin Freeman, despite him committing a heinous murder, I'm rooting for him in a sense. The way that the series has panned out, he's kind of framed his own brother and seemingly got away with killing his own wife. So I'm pleased about that. I don't know if that says something about me, whether I'm a sadistic bastard or not. I don't know, but interesting. The series has now jumped ahead a year, so certain plot lines have advanced, and I have it on good authority that the last two episodes of this series are cracking. Cool. So I'm really looking forward to watching those, and I really hope at some point that you get to check it out, because in all seriousness, it is one of the best TV series that I have certainly watched in the last few years.
It sounds good. It kind of sounds like you spoiled one or two things, but I'll probably forget it by then.
Well, I mean, the murder takes place. Oh yeah, I suppose I have.
I'll forget it. Don't worry.
Shit. Sorry. But yeah, it's cracking. If you do get a chance to watch it, it's only 10 episodes long, so I know it's taken me in ages to watch it. But if you want to just whiz through it, they're only 40 minutes each. So sweet. Yeah, cracking stuff.
Sweet.
I want to talk about Star Wars Rebels, which is a new animated TV show which has started actually tonight on I think the Disney XD channel, which is Disney's, I guess, cartoon channel for teenagers. So don't ask me why I'm watching it, but there you go.
I watch all kinds of crap, don't worry.
Yeah. Star Wars Rebels, it's a follow-up to the Clone Wars animated series, which I think finished a couple of years ago. It's in the same animated style. It's not quite, hand-drawn animation. It is CG in a sense. And it's going to bridge the gap between episodes. Let me get this right. Yeah, 3 and 4. So it's going to chart the progress and the rise of the rebellion, I guess. So I'm really looking forward. Obviously, you probably know I'm a Star Wars nut, so I'm looking forward to this TV show.
Okay.
Quite a lot. So I'm looking forward to getting into that and watching that tonight. And that which leads into some news that it's already been renewed for a second season, which is promising. So you'd expect them to, the network, to have liked what has been produced and to be confident enough that it's going to be successful enough to warrant a second season. So happy days. Star Wars Rebels starts tonight and has already got a second series. So
Doesn't matter if it's bad. Star Wars fans will watch it anyway, won't they?
I think you're right. Yeah.
Not saying it will be bad, but, you know, that's a reason it'll get renewed.
I hope it's not.
If it's got a Star Wars label on it, it'll get viewers.
What is interesting is I think this is going to be the first canon stuff in the Star Wars universe that Disney have had a role in producing.
Right.
So it's going to be interesting to see, having purchased that property, that IP, what they're going to now do with it. So I'm just interesting to see where, because I have high hopes for the film that they're producing, obviously Episode 7, mm-hmm. and I hope this is going to be of a similar quality. So we wait and see. But yeah, looking forward to that.
All right.
That's all I really have to talk about TV wise, and, you know, just watching the usual.
I'll leave some
bake. Do you watch the Bake Off, DLB?
The Great British Bake Off.
Yeah, do you?
No, I don't. I'm familiar with it, but yeah, no, not really.
I'm not sure. I can't remember if we've had this discussion before.
We mentioned it once.
Did we?
Yes.
It's coming to its finale now. So,
oh right.
Unfortunately, so. The girl I wanted to win, Martha, she left a couple of episodes ago. So, she cracked on her donuts.
Ah.
It was sad to see, but I think the final is next week, next Wednesday. So I shall be tuning into that. I love the Bake Off. I don't bake myself, but I just love watching other people bake, and I like eating eating cakes. There you go. That's my TV.
Fair enough. That was all right. I'm going to hit you next week with a retrospective look at Nightmare, one of my favourite kids' TV shows.
Awesome. I didn't know this. Brilliant. I love Nightmare as well.
Good on you.
Yeah. I liked the first few series as opposed to the later ones that they did. I think it went a bit. I think they changed the format around a bit, if I'm correct. But
yes, they kind of evolved it every year, but by the end of it, they were going outside and, yeah, just lost.
I didn't like.
Go on.
I didn't like when Traegard started to get helpers, little, you know, his like, females in his dungeon almost.
Well, Pickle was okay, the elf. But yeah, the genie woman wasn't so good. Traegard's awesome. I think he looks like my dad. Everyone else in my family disagrees, but I think he looks a lot like my dad.
Oh, awesome.
Also, I don't know if they would ever bring it back, but I would audition for the part of Traegard's son. Welcome, yes. Watchers of Illusion, to the Castle of Confusion. go into more detail about that. Go on.
Excellent. I just want to say that when I was watching that as a kid, the horn that used to play when the goblins would turn up. That used to shit me
terrifying.
Up.
Terrifying. Yeah. I'll see if I can find a sample of that horn. I'll put it on the show.
I look forward to that next week then. Yeah.
Okay.
Because that is one of my faves as well.
Sweet.
Cracking stuff. Shall we go and talk some video games? Talk some gaming?
Yes, sure. By all means.
Let's do it. Okay. Join us on the other side and we'll be chatting some video games.
Come in. Well, 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 look who's here. I haven't seen you in many a year. If I knew you were coming, I'd bake a cake, bake a cake, bake a cake. If I knew you were coming, I'd bake a cake. Hut-cha-do, hut-cha-do, hut-cha-do. Had you dropped me a letter, I'd have hired a band, grand band in the land. Had you dropped me a letter, I'd have hired a band and spread the welcome mat for you. Oh, I don't know where you came from, 'cause I don't know where you've been, but it really doesn't matter. Grab a chair and fill your platter and dig, dig, dig right in. If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake, hired a band. Goodness sake, if I knew you were coming, I'd have baked a cake. Hut-cha-do, hut-cha-do, hut-cha-do.
And welcome back. We're going to talk some video games. Games, games, games. DRB.
Yes.
I first want to start off by discussing some news I gleaned from the internet about the new WWE 2K15 video game.
Is this podcast related, or are we getting away with this?
I think it's fine. I think okay. It's fine. It's video game related. It's fine. It's all good. Right. They 2K announced this week they gave details of the career mode that's going to be featured in this year's game.
Okay.
Now, I wanted to bring this up, A, because we're lovers of wrestling, mm-hmm. and also because the mode sounds absolutely awesome.
All right.
From what I understand, you create your own wrestler. So you could be, I don't know, you could be a Great Khali lookalike if you wished.
A Great Khali. Oh.
Exactly. And also, you are signed up to WWE NXT, where you are trained by a digital Bill DeMott and given career advice by a digital Vicky Guerrero. And you progress onto the main WWE Raw card, where there are multiple branching storylines based on how entertaining your matches are. Now, that's what I think is key. Because before wrestling video games are usually just treated as fighting games.
Yeah, win or lose.
Yeah, beat a dude, win or lose, as you say. What I think is interesting about this game is you're ranked as you would be, I guess, in real life on how entertaining your match is.
Oh, I fear for Khali.
Oh, no.
That's a botchcast joke, folks.
Interesting, yes. If you are a fan of wrestling, go check out the Botchcast.
Yes.
Every Friday. But so, yeah, this mode sounds awesome, and I like how it's, bringing in elements of real wrestling matches and a real wrestling career into it.
It does sound interesting. It's a different take on it, isn't it?
Yeah. So, you know, I'm assuming if you're fighting John Cena in a title match and then you just keep, if you do a Brock Lesnar on him and just give him 19...
Just kill him.
Give him 19 what they call German suplexes, mm-hmm. then I would say that's not going to be ranked as high as, say, I don't know, a match with multiple moves, with multiple false finishes.
So I can see problems with it, but yeah, it's interesting. It's an interesting concept.
I think so. If I am correct, the PS4 and Xbox One version has actually been delayed by a couple of weeks. I guess they just want to fine-tune it for the new consoles. It's out on the PS4, PS3 and 360 on October 28th, so at the end of this month.
Okay.
And November 18th for PS4 and Xbox One. Personally, I can't wait.
Sweet.
Cannot wait. So that's my gaming news, really.
Yeah, that sounds good.
It does. As to what I've been playing this week, I've been balls deep in my PlayStation 4 this week, as much as I can. I've been playing Destiny, which I think I spoke about a couple of weeks ago. It's the new
Halo rebooted, yes. Kind of.
Basically, yes. Yeah. It's made by Bungie, the guys behind Halo. It's essentially a first-person shooter / MMO game. / RPG kind of thing. So I'm really enjoying it. I mean, I've heard some complaints that the system for obtaining loot is kind of broken, in that you can grind for hours and hours and not get much reward for your grinding. Characters only level up to level 20, so that can be an issue because that doesn't take you long to do. I think a lot of the issues are end-game issues, so once you've completed the game and got to the highest level, what do you do from there?
Right.
But I think it's one of those games that I think they have a 10-year plan for it, so they're going to continue to add in content to it. So I'm happy just to plough through in single-player, and, you know, so far I'm thoroughly enjoying it. I'm not really a multiplayer kind of chap, to be honest. So.
No, me neither, so it's difficult for me to really make judgment on that.
But do you have much history or experience? I mean, did you play Halo at all? Did you have an Xbox?
Yeah, no, I never had an Xbox. I played Halo a fair bit. It wasn't my thing, to be honest. It's
Are you generally a first-person shooter dude? Or
no, no, not at all.
No.
That's why I think when things like Call of Duty and Medal of Honor and stuff like that came along, I was just lost. I was like, what? I don't care about this shit.
I think you would, if you were ever going to play one, I mean, I know you like your RPGs.
Yeah.
I guess if you're ever going to play one, then this may be the one to get.
I guess
there are role-playing game elements to
right.
it. But I will say it's predominantly what you're doing is shooting people in a first person perspective. So perhaps you won't like it.
Yeah, it's not. I hate it. I'm just not that interested. It's not in your it. Thing.
Not your bag. Mm-hmm. So that's Destiny. That's tidying me over really until my next purchase. I think is going to be The Evil Within on PlayStation 4, which is releasing on October 14. This is going to be the game that I'm going to feature for my Scared Bitch project.
Okay.
It's a horror game. It's developed by Shinji Mikami, who directed Resident Evil. I think he did the first Resident Evil. No, he's definitely did Resident Evil 4, which is one of my favourite games of all time, as everyone knows, or I think I've mentioned it before. So I have high hopes. This is a similar game in a similar style. I think it's in a bit of a period setting.
Like the Tudors?
No, more Victorian, I believe.
Oh.
So, yeah, but what I like about it is it's more... It seems to be more psychological in that, obviously, as the title suggests, a lot of the gameplay is within your own consciousness, so shit's going down in your mind. And creepy shit's happening, man.
Mm.
It looks quite awesome. Similar style to Resident Evil 4. So, you know, over-the-shoulder, third-person, shooty-shooty, zombies kind of thing.
Resident Evil.
Oh, mate, I love that game. I was tempted to crack out the GameCube for my Scared Bitch project to play some Resi 4. But I felt I needed to get some money out of my PlayStation 4. And it seemed... fitting that I should play The Evil Within, so that's what I'm going to be doing.
Enjoy it whilst it's relevant.
Mm. Exactamundo. So, anything you're going to be playing in the future, DLB? Any plans to?
No plans. But by all means, feel free to suggest things during the week.
Mm. Do you? I don't know, really. Perhaps you should be playing Resident Evil 4. Have you? I assume you played it.
Not 4, no.
Have you not? Oh, no. Mate. Wow.
No. I get lost on all this crap.
I love it, mate. Love it. So there you go, video games. Film. Should we talk some film?
Sure.
Let's do this. Shall we talk some film?
I don't see why not.
Let's do it. I'm going to start with some news I gleaned from Twitter Film website. Hmm. Are you a fan of Tarantino?
You hit and miss, but yeah.
I agree. Very hit and miss. Recently, more misses than hits, I would say.
Yeah, agree, yeah.
For me, anyway. Tarantino's next project is entitled The Hateful Eight. My new story is that the Tarantino's The Hateful Eight will begin shooting in December in Colorado.
And what part will I be playing?
Well, I tell you what, mate, this film it has got me excited. Yeah. It sounds like a Tarantino, I don't want to say remake, but I'm going to say homage to the film Stagecoach.
Oh, right.
Which I think is a 66, I think, film. I think it's got John Wayne in, about a rabble of characters who are travelling across the United States frontier, all in a stagecoach. Mm-hmm. You know, it's a bit of a character piece, etc. And I think The Hateful Eight follows a similar theme. It's the story states... that according to the Denver Post, cameras will begin rolling on the 8th of December with the film to be shot entirely in Colorado on 70mm film. The film will operate on a $44 million budget, with the report claiming that this will be the biggest production to shoot in the state since the 1969 version of True Grit. Ooh. The film will follow a stagecoach of disparate characters forced to seek shelter in a nearby tavern during a freak snowstorm. With a collection of hugely combustible personalities under one roof, tensions soon begin to boil over. Now, this is the awesome bit.
Okay.
The official cast has yet to be confirmed. But Kurt Russell, Jennifer Lawrence, Samuel L. Jackson, and Michael Madsen, as you would expect, and DRB have all been strongly linked to the project.
There you go, brother.
With a shoot fast approaching, hopefully they will be confirmed sooner rather than later. If that is the cast that's going to be in it, then that is that already sounds awesome. Kurt Russell.
That can be awesome.
Yeah, so I'm looking forward to that. I've seen Inglourious Basterds. Although I don't think it's one of his better films, I enjoyed it. It was watchable. I haven't seen Django.
No, me neither.
That's the thing with Tarantino. There used to be a point where I would look forward to it and couldn't wait to watch the next Tarantino release. But I just can't be arsed now. I really can't, and it's sad.
I don't get as excited about it anymore either.
No. So I'm looking forward to, but this sounds good, and I'm looking forward to The Hateful Eight. I guess that's going to be out in next year sometime. I don't know when. Probably.
Yeah, filming December. Maybe, more likely 2016. Yeah, but
yeah, it sounds like a winter release, doesn't it? With the themes and particularly the snowstorm, etc. So then perhaps they'll chuck it out in the winter time.
Yeah, maybe lead up to Oscars, that sort of thing.
Yes, exactly. But that's my film reel news, really.
I've heard they start filming, or are starting to film, Pirates 5.
I saw that, yes. Are you a fan of the Pirates series?
Yeah, I'm okay with it, but I mean, it's the only real problem is, like, 2 and 3 just got really confusing.
Yeah.
Way too long.
If they're ever on the telly, I always get confused which one it is. Because they all seem to have similar titles as well. Curse of the such and such, I don't know, to here and back, I don't know, whatever they're called. But yeah, I could never tell you which one it actually is on. And obviously they all look the same. But yeah, I mean, they're all right. The Pirates films, you know, good, trashy, good popcorn films, really, aren't they? Entertaining flicks.
My favourite part of it is Jeffrey Rush's Barbossa. I know he's confirmed for the next one, so I'm happy enough.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Excellent.
Arr.
I haven't really watched much this week. I did watch a film called, and it was terrible, Willow Creek.
I thought you were going to say Willow.
Willow's amazing. I think we could do a whole show on Willow.
We could.
But that's for another week.
Again.
Willow. I've lost all train of thought now.
Sorry, Willow Creek.
Willow Creek. It is, how do I describe it? To start off with, I need to qualify, this is essentially a Blair Witch Project complete knockoff.
Okay.
It's about a couple, it's a found footage film, so the for some reason they're taking their camera and documenting everything they do, including every conversation they have with each other. But they go off into some woods in Colorado, I believe, on the search for Bigfoot. And it almost follows the same structure to the Blair Witch Project, where the first half, they're interviewing residents of the local village. They're all saying, oh, you don't want to go down there. I don't know why they're from...
For my part of the world.
Yeah. Don't go down there. Oh, no. Bigfoot down there.
You don't want to go near Bigfoot, you know. No.
But it's really shit. There's no tension in it at all. It's not scary. You never see Bigfoot. All you hear, there's a scene where they're just quivering in their tent together. And they hear just this knocking of wood and these footsteps that you assume is Bigfoot. But this all climaxes into this end scene where Bigfoot is seemingly attacking their tent. So the couple then obviously run away from their tent into the woods, like in the Blair Witch Project. And then they're confronted by this fat, old, naked, old woman. And that is basically it. Then you hear one of the characters, you hear what sounds like their death, and then that's it. And you don't. It's very, very disappointing. Strange enough, it was directed and written by Bobcat Goldthwaite, screechy guy from the Police Academy films.
Oh God!
Yeah. Oh, yeah. It's all like this, like that dude.
Well, I'm not sure how. Okay.
Yeah, it's very strange, but it wasn't good. Let's put it that way. But that kind of leads me into the films I'm going to be watching for my Scared Bitch project. So in the following 4 weeks, run up to Halloween, I've picked some horror films, a couple of which are my all-time favourites, two of which I haven't actually seen, but I have in my collection and haven't watched yet. So I'm going to start with VHS, which and another film called Trick or Treat, which are kind of similar films in that they are compilation films, so they're several short films in one larger film, if that makes sense.
Yeah, gotcha.
So I haven't seen those films. I've heard great things about them. I have them on Blu-ray. I haven't watched them. So for the first 2 weeks, my first two reviews will be on those two films. Culminating, I shall then review with The Shining, which is one of my all-time favourites. And on our Halloween show, I shall be taking a look at my all-time favourite Halloween film, The Blair Witch Project.
Okay.
I love that film so much. So, DRB, if you want to play along and, you know, discuss the films with me as well, then feel free to source any of those that you can, and we'll thrash it out, as it were.
I'll thrash so, furiously.
Whatever you do in your own house is, you know, that's up to you. But
my research lab.
That's another Botchcast in joke for fans of the Botchcast. So there you go. I'm really going to be, you know, consuming lots of horror films this month because I want to get into the spirit of things on the run up to the big day, as it were. It's strange. I actually look forward to Halloween more than I do Christmas now, I think.
Really?
I think I do.
Oh, that's just
crazy. I never used to be like that way, mate, to be honest.
Mm. Well, I'll bring the spirit come Christmas time.
Don't get me wrong, I love Christmas, but Halloween, just I don't know, in the last few years I don't know what it is, I just love it. But there you go, that is our look at some films. Well, not really, but it's good. So there you go, that was our Renaissance Print podcast number 13.
It's in there. The books.
I've lost my notes. I'm all over the place.
Well, it's only last thing to say is if you want to email us, it's therenaissancemenpodcast@gmail.com. You can find us on Twitter @RenaissancePod. You can find Stuart
at SkinBear.
Way to be on cue. And you can find me at DavidBridge1985. If you're listening on Libsyn, be sure to subscribe either on iTunes or Stitcher or Player FM. Either one's good. We don't care.
No, we don't. there you go. That's the show. It was a good one. So, yes.
It's the first time I've had to tidy things up like that.
I know. I'm gone. I'm a shell of a man now. I don't know. I don't know what's happening. I don't know where I am. Don't know what's going on.
Would you like to request a song to go out on?
I was just going to ask you the same thing. Is there anything pertinent this week's show?
Related.
So, you know, what have we discussed? What have we learned this week? We've learned do not discharge your gun into someone else's house.
Do not discharge 100 times a day.
Particularly beside your dead father's corpse.
Correct.
Yeah. We've learned that I love Halloween.
Dude.
We've learned that
I just realized I'm not recording.
Really?
No, I'm just joking.
You bastard! We've learned DRB is quite the prankster.
When I want to be.
Bastard. Well done. And we've learned I'm a romantic soul. Tender soul.
6 out of 10.
Yeah. So, there you go. Join us on next Friday for the Botchcast, as always. And on the following Monday for next week's podcast, where we'll be chewing the cuds.
Doing it all over again.
Yes, we do. Because we love it, don't we, DRB?
I guess. Any parting shots?
Parting shots. Parting shots. Do I have a nugget of wisdom for you all? All I can say is never rob another man's rhubarb.
Okay, I don't see how that's relevant to anything.
I don't know, it just popped in my head.
Fair enough. Well, on those words, on my bombshell. Let's go out with this. See you next week, listener.
Bye.
Yeah. What is it good for?
Absolutely
nothing.
Uh-huh.
To me.